yourself. It's just you and what's around you, and it gives you a more clear picture of nature. And the sound of the water and the wind blowing through the trees and all these things that you're kind of overlooking if there's something else distracting you. Hunting and fishing gives me this connection with nature that you can't get any other way. And it gives you this closeness to the wild. My name's Dominic Watts. I'm a large mammal biologist with Kenai National Wildlife Refuge. Hunting and fishing allow me to kind of be part of this bigger thing, this bigger system, a bigger experience. Hunters and anglers were the first conservationists, and they started seeing the things that they loved. They start seeing those things go away. There's this inherent need to protect that place, to really inundate yourself in the experience in the system. And fishing allows me to do that. Hunting allows me to do that as well. Kenai Refuge is a vast expanse of wilderness. It's a place to get away. The water is the lifeblood of the whole system. You're watching something that shaped everything that we see today. All the water in this lake system is coming from this just continuous flow from the glaciers downstream. And then you keep going up. It's cracked ice, hundreds of feet thick, as far as you can see all around you. These glaciers are slowly moving downstream through time, carving out the landscape, providing those things like spawning habitats for salmon that all the other species are relying on. As an angler, you enter this part of the system where these sockeye salmon are coming up out of the ocean. They're coming back in to spawn. Every time I walk up to a stream, I still feel this just kind of sense of wonder that there's that many fish coming up into the system. You're becoming part of this bigger picture and this thing that's been going on essentially since the beginning of time. For me, hunting and fishing is so central in my life, and it's always been this kind of main component and driving factor. Just growing up, I always had this kind of urge to come to Alaska. Even as a kid, you know, all I wanted to do was be outside. And it originally started with my father. An ideal future is where these things are conserved in perpetuity. And generations from now, people can go out and have the same experiences like I've had. There's this inherent need to protect that place because you want to come back, you want to share that for the next generation.